Hello, my friends. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you're all having a great day. I do have eyelashes on in this video. I just got done recording the Esquito video that you've probably already seen, but I decided to leave them on so that I could really say whether I like them or not, and I'm getting very used to them, I must say. Okay, so it is empties time, end of October. I will also have a favorites video coming up, but for today, it's going to be my empties. Some of these things are repeats. You've seen them every month practically because I go through them every month, so I share them to let you know that I do love them, and some items are new. And with my empties, I like to give you a little review and let you know if I would purchase them again or not. So let's get started. Gotta make a little room for my trash pile here. Okay, the first item you see every month, and it is my Tom's Wicked Fresh Cool Mountain Mint mouthwash. I've explained why I use this. I buy it by the bottles. And I use it because it is the only mouthwash that does not make the inside of my mouth peel. And the reason why I go through so much mouthwash is because I use an inhaler and I must rinse out so that I don't get any thrush or anything like that. So, here you go. Tom's Wicked Fresh. I buy it at Target. I will continue to buy this product. Okay, I finished up some shampoos. You've heard me talk about these before. I love the Matrix Biolage Fiber Strong Shampoo and Conditioner. I really think that this just is a phenomenal shampoo. I think it's for fine, stressed hair, but I think it would be good for any hair. And I will tell you that I just think that using this shampoo has changed the condition of my hair. So I really love these products. It's the Biolage Fiber Strong Shampoo and Conditioner. Love, love, love. I have been buying it for a very long time. I always have it. Okay, last month you heard me talk about one of these, and it was in a different flavor scent. So I went through the other one I had. I have been I'm trying to work through things just so I can really share my empties with you. I'm one of those little creatures. I get excited about something, I open it up, and I've got so many things going at once, and I enjoy that, but I've just been really trying to focus on finishing things up. And I actually got these last December, and last month I pronounced it wrong, and it is Geisha by Bally James, not Geisha, but most people say Geisha. It's Geisha. Anyway, it is a body wash, and I use it as a shower gel, and this is in the scent Moonflower. Last month was a different one. These are just exquisite in scent. I think they would make a fabulous gift for anybody because they're just so different, and they're so feminine, and they're just really, they make you feel good, and they don't dry out the skin. So again, that is Geisha by Bally James, and this is the Moonflower. The containers, you know, I don't love the container. They're not absolutely gorgeous or anything like that, but what's inside of them just makes up for it. They're just beautiful, just beautiful. I've been using the Bally James products for a very long time. I've used the body lotions. My favorite scent, and I wish it would come in the shower gel, is Ritual. Oh, if you love patchouli, you will love Ritual. Okay, this product here, I actually had my favorites last month, and this was actually recommended by a subscriber, so I went out and got it, and I don't know how I ever shaved without this. I absolutely love it. I buy it at my grocery store. It probably costs about $2 more than most shave creams, but I'm telling you, I get a beautiful shave out of this, and I have the Peaceful Patchouli scent. It comes in several scents. And it's a 4-in-1 moisture shave that softens, smooths, soothes, and moisturizes. And I will tell you, I feel it does all of those. I think I get the best shave with this. Less nicks, and it doesn't even say that on here, but I think I get less nicks, and my skin really stays moisturized. But I really think it softens the hair. You have to give these things time, though. What I do is I just put it on my legs, and then I put my conditioner on, and you know, so and so, and I let it really soften the hair. But fabulous, just fabulous. Kiss my face. Love, love, love this shave cream. Thank you to the subscriber who told me about it. Next product is, I finished up a box of the Ulla Henriksen Power Peel. I did a sample sundae on these. You know how much I love them. I feel they're very effective, a great at-home peel. They can be purchased at Ulta and Sephora, probably online at Ulla Henriksen's site. just a fabulous product. I really like it. Really like it. Okay. Next product is something that Joelle sent me. There'll be a lot of empties from Joelle in here because I'm really trying to finish things up. And this one here I had talked about a long time ago, and I didn't even realize that it's not sold at our clearance counters. No one in my area, the clearance counters, have ever even heard of it. They told me, no, I must have the name wrong. Well, it's right here in front of me. How can I have the name wrong? But anyway, Joelle did send me another bottle of this, and I really, really, really like this. It's a gentle exfoliating toner, and I really like to use this. I basically use this one when my skin's feeling a little dull. I'll do my glycolic wash, and then I'll double up on it and do this. Or when I do my facials, my at-home facials, I like to use this one because I just really liked, I feel that when you keep your skin, and I'm leaning more towards chemical exfoliants these days over the granule, I just feel they're far more effective than the others. So I really feel that all the money that we spend on our skincare, I don't care if it's drugstore or if it's high-end, when you use exfoliating products such as the glycolics or things that are meant to exfoliate, I really think that your other products work fabulously. So this is the Clarins Gentle Exfoliator Brightening Toner with Tamarind and White Nettle. You probably will be able to order this online someplace, but if you're going to your Clarins counter, they do not have this one. Now, there is another one that they try to sell you and tell you it's this, but it is not. This is the one that I feel is most effective because I bought the other one because that's what the girl told me, and it's not the same. I also, another recommendation from a subscriber, I bought the Emma Hardy Amazing Face Moringa Cleansing Balm. This, I love the smell of. I love the way it works. I love the way my skin felt after it. What's really nice about the cleansing balms, and I do like to use a cleansing balm to remove all the sunscreen, all the makeup, really get all of that gunk off, and then I'll use my regular Clarisonic and all that kind of stuff. But I really like this one because when you put it on, you can also use it as a massage. It's got a great slip to it, so you can really massage all of that, you know, makeup and really break it down. But then when you put your hands under the water and then you go over your the cream itself, it emulsifies into a lather and it just rinses really clean. It is really great. Has to be ordered online in the States. Okay, and it's the Emma Hardy Moringa Face, Amazing Face Moringa Cleansing Balm. Okay, love it. Would get it again, probably will. I have several cleansing balms that I want to get through. I have a Diptyque. I've used Ren. My least favorite of them is Clinique, but I've never been a fan of many Clinique products, but I do have the Clinique. I have several of them that I'm going to try, and some I've already tried, but so far that one's leading the pack. The Diptyque, oh, and I have a Darphin that Joelle sent me that actually was in that. I did a video a while ago on the 10 thing French skincare products you must have, and that was one of them. So she sent me that. Another product from Joelle that will be very hard for us to find, but I'm going to show it because I do have a European audience, and also I have many people who travel to Paris and ask me, what French skincare products should I get when I'm over there? If you can find this, you should try this. I love this. Joelle can only get it when she is in Paris or she has it sent to her from Paris. She can't even buy it in Martinique. So this is, I don't know if you'll be able to find this throughout Europe, but I know France has this product. And it is a black soap with olive oil by Marius Fabre. This is really fabulous. Now, if you're thinking, oh, black soap, is it going to smell good? No, it doesn't smell good at all. It resembles a tar-like substance. It doesn't have a nice smell at all. I mean, it's not highly fragrant or anything. It's just, there's nothing. It's not a nice fragrance, but I will tell you what this does. This, I like to, you know, take a nice hot shower, and then I will just take this soap and I'll just use my scrubbing gloves and really scrub, and then I leave it set on me for a few minutes. I swear it softens the skin and prepares it for all the other treatments. So this is really, really nice. I mean, I use a lot of this in the winter, a lot, because I really get in there and exfoliate. And then when I put all the other products on, I just think they work even better. So if you are in Paris, you will want to try this. I use it on my face. You can use it all over. So like before I'm going to do a facial, I'll get in the shower and I really do a good scrub down with this. I don't use anything harsh to scrub, but I really get in there so that it really gets my skin ready for everything. I love it, and that's what the container will look like, but just a fabulous product. All right, next is a hair product, and I have been talking about this since day one on YouTube. I love this product. It is probably my most favorite hair oil. I will always, always have it. And it is the Lanza Healing Strength Neem Plant Silk Serum. I love this. I put this on in my, at nighttime. I wash my hair in the morning every day. So at night, I always put an oil treatment on before I go to bed. It does not get on your pillowcases. That is the number one thing I'm always asked when I say about a hair oil treatment. But I will always mix some of this in with whatever oil I'm using. And I also like to squirt this into my hair mask. Just really, really a fabulous, fabulous hair oil. And I do feel it heals the hair. So love this product. Smells great. Sometimes when I'll blow dry my hair and I'll think, my hair is just so lackluster. Take a squirt of this, rub it in my hands, rub it through. And I swear it just brings it back to life. Absolutely love this product. Okay, finished up two sprays, so I'll show them to you both. This is the Mario Badescu, and this is the facial spray with aloe herbs and rose water. I like to use this in the summertime, just nice for refreshing. You know, if you've been out, you've been working out in the yard or sweating, whatever, you can come in, wash your face, and give it a nice spritz. Or just, you know, you want to freshen up, or you want to use it as your toner. It doesn't really matter. Or you want to use it over your powdered makeup just to take that powdery look away. Really, really nice. You can find this at Ulta. Very inexpensive, the Mario Badescu products. Okay, and I've talked about this one several times. This is my BioElements Power Peptide Spray. I love this spray. In the winter, I'm going to be spraying this as soon as I get out of the shower on my body just to give it some peptides because I do turn into the crocodile lady come wintertime. I'm that all year round, but in the winter, oh, double duty. I finished up a Max Fix Plus. You all know what you use this for. After you put powder makeup on, if you just spritz, or you can use it to dampen your brush to apply some of your makeup. Whatever you want, but I finished that. I would always have a Max Fix Plus with me. And I would also, what was the other? I probably would not buy the Mario Badescu rose water again, but definitely the BioElements water. Okay, then two other products that Joelle sent me, I finished up. And now, if you have very dry skin, it is good to get in the habit, especially through the winter months, if your climate changes like mine, to get into using cleansing oils on your body or cleansing shower creams. They are better for dry skin than gels, during the winter especially. So Joelle had sent me this one, and I finished it, and it was very nice. Now this is going to be one of those products that we in the United States probably can't find, maybe online, but I know that the European audience will be able to. And it's the Aderma, and it's their emollient cleansing oil. It's very, very nice. It's a small bottle, but it's very, very nice. And this is the company. And that is what the product looks like. Very nice. A very, very light green scent to it, but really just keeps the skin really moisturized while you're showering. I think there's something beautiful about warm water and oils that just really make the skin respond. Okay, then the next, and I love this argan oil. For argan oil, I use argan oil for many things. If my skin feels a little irritated, you know, I did something that kind of irritated it, I'll use argan oil over it with a little bit of Neosporin mixed in. I'm a Neosporin freak. But anyway, this argan oil, I really like. It has a great slip. I use it during facial massage. I use it with my little cups that I have, the Belladachi, or the little French blue cups I have. You know, it helps them to really glide across the face. The same when you're doing your massage. You know, an argan oil is nice. You can use any oil, but I like this one. And again, this is the Naturelle d'Argan You hear my French? Okay, so that is what that. Finish my toothpaste. Every month I have a toothpaste, Pro Enamel. Gotta remember, all that coffee, tea, and wine we drink erodes the enamel off the teeth, so we gotta protect it. Two lip balms that Joelle sent me. These are drugstore brands, but they were both very nice, so I just thought I would share them. The Homeo Stick and the Mixia. Okay, those. I got some mascaras in here. I tried to finish everything up. Let me make sure I got all of those. Okay, I have two by Armani, Giorgio Armani. I have the Giorgio Armani Eyes to Kill and the Eyes to Kill Extreme. I really liked both of these mascaras. However, I wouldn't buy them again. I would if I wasn't somebody who liked to constantly try new mascaras. I do have mascaras that I buy all the time, Definisils and Bobbi Brown Smoky Eye, but these are very, very nice. This is something you have, because it's expensive. So, you know, this really, if you have small lashes or you really need some definition, these are great mascaras, but I don't have an Armani counter by me to just walk up and buy it. So I probably wouldn't buy those again, but I did like both of them. Matter of fact, when I first bought it, I was like in love with it. So another one I just mentioned is the Bobbi Brown Smoky Eye Mascara. I love this mascara, but I will say that it starts to get a little funky on you after 2 months of use. But I do not like any rubber plastic wand mascaras. These are all the good old-fashioned mascara brushes. So I love that. And then I have a sample of the Bobbi Brown Smoky Eye that I finished up. And then this is one of those eyelash enhanced growers. And don't waste your money on this if you see it. It's the Nutrilash ALK Cosmetics. It did nothing. Nothing at all. I would not waste my money on this. So don't buy that, peeps. Okay, this you can find in your grocery stores, Whole Foods, Wegmans carries it. It's Michelle. It's a natural line. And this one here is their Serious Hyaluronic Firming Serum, and it's preventative formula with copper minerals to boost youthful collagen. This is a very nice natural line. Very nice. It was a nice hyaluronic acid, but I would not buy this again. It is not my favorite. But it is, for those of you who are really into the natural lines, the Michelle line is very, very nice. Again, in your grocery store, it's not super cheap, but it's a very nice line. Okay, I have some masks that I did finish up, and I will let all of my masking friends know I'm going to be having a mask sale. I don't want to get into a lot of details here, but there's not going to be a store. One, I am not computer store savvy enough to build the store myself. I had to really think about what would I sell on a store. I really don't have anything other than the mask. And I like selling them, but I don't know that I would always have, you know, a big supply to keep on a store. So I'm going to continue on doing my mask sale every couple of months or so. But I'm going to continue doing them the way that I was doing them, because to have someone build and create a store website for me is very expensive, and I weighed out the pros and cons of it. And for me, my lifestyle, and what I want to do with it, it's just not worth it for me. So I'm going to be having a mask sale, and I'm going to be doing a video after this one to show you the mask that will be in it. So keep looking for that if you're interested in my martini mask sale. I did finish some. I have the hyaluronic acid that I finished. I did a banana wrinkle cream. I did the snail collagen. And then I have some eye masks that I did. My Shiseido Benefiance eye mask I love. I did a couple of those. I did a couple of the Institute Estederm eye patches, And you know, there was a time when eye patches weren't available, eye mask, and now they're becoming more and more available. These I found at Target, and this is a really nice comforting mask. It's a revitalizing eye mask, and it's a bamboo line. Really nice. No, not Target, I'm sorry. TJ Maxx and Marshalls has them. And you get like four in a box for under $5. And they're really nice masks. And then the Bliss Triple Oxygen Instant Energizing Eye Mask. I tried. You know, I like this mask. It's a very good mask. But I have Martini Mask. And the reason why you see so many few sheet masks right now is because I'm really trying to go through my cream mask so that I can share those with you too. And then I also have a jar of the Colleen Rothschild Extreme Recovery Cream. I like Colleen's face oil and I like her enzyme peel. This moisturizer was just not enough for me. And I know that it's suggested that you mix it in with the oil, which I did, but it just is not enough moisture for me. So I wouldn't get this again, although I do like, I love the hand cream, the face oil, and the enzyme peel. But this one here, it just wasn't enough for me. And I didn't really even feel I was anti-aging when I was using it. It has a wonderful texture. Okay, so now this here is my last that I will not buy again. I didn't even finish up for a couple reasons. One, this bottle is just impossible for me to squeeze to get any out of it, even when it's open. It's a very hard bottle, and I just thought if somebody really has bad arthritis, they're not getting anything out of this. It also has a lot of those little microbeads in it that are not good for our waters. I'm not one to come on and preach about anything. I make choices for myself. I don't criticize, or I don't have, you do what you need to do in your life, but for me, it's just not good for our ocean, our waters. The fishy can't digest that, and it's just not good for them. So I just stopped using it, and also the exfoliation level in this really did not impress me. Okay, so this is the Bliss Fabulous Foaming Body Wash 2-in-1 Cleanser Exfoliator. I did buy this at TJ Maxx for not very much money, but I hated the bottle, and I don't feel the product is super effective, and like I said, it's just not good for our water, our environment. So we got to keep our fishies safe too, because you like to eat the fishy. I don't eat the fishy, but you like to eat the fishies. Okay, so there are my empties. What did you guys finish up this month? Anything new you tried that you just loved and you finished up right away? Love hearing from you all. Thanks for stopping by. Don't forget, subscribe. We're anti-aging here. Be happy, be healthy, be beautiful, and most of all, my friends, be lovable. I love you all. Bisous, my friends. Bisous.